Hello, hello.
Can they hear us?
Yeah. So Finio looks pretty comfortable here in the Falcon matchup. He's at a little higher percent. Like, he's spacing pretty well. I mean, he just got hit as I started to talk.
I didn't see game one, so Finio obviously took that one.
Yeah, no, he was moving pretty well around what EG was trying to do. I don't know much about EG's playstyle, but I know that Finio, he likes his bread and butters. He feels very comfortable with those.
So a little background on EG. He's from Michigan. I think he's like considered number two on their PR. Mm-hmm. He actually took first place in his placement pool yesterday, which is pretty impressive.
Yeah.
I think he had Dark Horse in his pool. I don't remember who else, but he didn't lose at all in placement pools, which is pretty impressive.
That's impressive. I think he's the only noms to place in D1, but they had a few work their way up, so that's really good. See if EG can continue his success here. Can you make it back in the depths? And EG takes game two. So yeah, EG, he's getting warmed up here. Turn Finio off his game a bit.
Yeah, EG had Dark Horse, Rusty, Cam, Monty, Monad. So a few decent guys in there.
Yeah. Nice. Back in for game three. This is all best of five. I'm sure you'll read in the bottom. But, Finio needs to, just get him off stage. Falcon's very capable.
That was a nice edge guard by Finio.
Very nice. Had the right move at the right spot. Didn't get his pivot there. He wanted the turnaround grab, but wasn't quite able to get it. EG missed that dash input. He definitely wanted to dash there, and he ended up walking. He didn't get punished, hard for it or anything, but not exactly what he was looking for. He's tossed off stage, edge guard. Ooh, reverses it. Finio's doing a really good job escaping without the EG. Gets shoulder checked right at the ledge there. Just costing him. Oh, off the top with the hook.
I was going to say, is that going to kill? Because a lot of the times Falcon's up air is just like completely stale.
Takes
and
forever.
Doesn't kill.
It's going to be good for EG. That's a
nice combo.
Finio
DIing in for his life. It didn't save him.
Yeah, trying to get inside Falcon to dodge it. Oh, gets a reverse hit. Did not want that. That is for sure. Gets the standard. That's another stop. Finio's got to figure something out here. He's got to figure out why he's getting rocked by these standards. He's going to stop getting hit by him. Start up. Gets his up there to knock Falcon out of range. Banana's at zero, so he's doing good.
Gets grabbed. Oh. Nice up B out of that.
Yeah, that was a very nice escape. Smart to not try and, push him and attack there. Because, it could have cost him. He got shield up or had a counterattack ready.
That's a risky nair approach by EG. F smash, edge hog.
Only 49%.
Alright.
Very, very doable. Falcon's one of those characters. He can die at zero. Doesn't need a whole lot done with him, but,
Ops for the down air after that up smash. I wonder if up air would have sent him too far away.
Did you not get the. Oh! Falcon punch in neutral. The me special. I like it. It strikes fear.
There it is.
It's not the best move.
There it is.
Definitely lets people know, hey, I'm not afraid to throw it out.
Yeah. So
EG actually saying he didn't want the punch. So
Finio probably gonna stick Pikachu here. Oh, yeah. He has a Falcon and a Mario. He could pull out, but
Kirby. I've seen him pull out, but I don't know if he's ready for this level.
Kirby? Finio's Kirby?
Yeah, he's got one, but I don't know how well it would do here.
Yeah,
he's
I don't know about that.
Feeling himself.
But I mean, this is a matchup that it's like it would be good to have like a Mario counter pick for.
Yeah, Mario does surprise me as well. But,
Fire Blaster pretty famously uses Mario as a Falcon counter pick.
Yeah, Finio opting to stay peeking here, stick to his guns. He's not getting his turnarounds. He's getting up tilt, but he's not getting the turnaround. Falcon's at too low of a percent to up tilt grab.
Yeah.
He's going to be a little higher if he wants the turnaround. Yeah, there it is again.
Oh, jumped right into that F smash.
Has no chance to DI that. Got him off stage, grabs ledge, gets in there. That's what Finio's game plan should be. Just stay at the ledge, figure out a way to get Falcon to turn around and off stage, and then just get them. Space him out with back airs, gets him off. See how he gets it. Attacks out 1% with forward air. Next they're off stage, we'll send him a little farther, give him some more time to figure out a move to try to get him Falcon.
Looks like they're playing a little bit more careful than they were games 1 and 2.
Yeah, they're definitely playing some heavy puts.
And 3.
Just trying to see who's going to hit who.
Nice mix-up on that, no tech.
Yeah. Ooh, chases him down. Trades, but that was definitely a very favorable trade for him. Got EG's stock loss. I'm sure Finia's pleased with that. That zip zap seems so dangerous, just the all the way out. But, ooh!
Wow, yo. Surprised that connected.
The longest hook. Oh, get up, up smash?
Yeah, against Pikachu, the no tech mix up is pretty good because, like, if you're just laying on the ground, he can't grab, he can't follow up with grab unless he does it right away.
Because his tech chase and grab is pretty easy for him.
Yeah, Pikachu can react pretty. That's gonna be it.
Finio takes game 2. Alright, Finio looked pretty solid there. Like, he looked like he was getting back to his game plan from game 1. You know, just get him off the ledge, figure out a way to gimp him.
We got a game 5 situation here, so it looks like EG is getting a little bit of support or coaching from his friends from Michigan. Velocity Jones, and I don't recognize the other guy. But.
That is Ace.
Oh, is that Ace? Okay.
He's a Pika player, so he's probably telling him what to watch out.
Game 5, let's go.
The wrong way. Cost him that stop. Finio going all the way across the lane. Turn around grab that he wants. Gets the gimp. Oh, gets hugged.
Oh.
Turns it into another gimp. 2-stock swing for Finio.
Wow. Finio needed those 2 stocks.
Yeah. That was very good. Good 2-stock sequence for Finio. Now he has the time to slow it down. He's got the percent deficit, but I think it's 20%. Hits in his arm. He's already made up that difference. He's got him off stage again.
Oh.
Forces his hand, makes him go too low. Alright, EG on last stock here. Ooh, getting risky, going off stage. Forward air, jab grab. This could be it. Oh, he gets hugged. He's gonna get back on stage for that. Alright, Finio needs to just be very patient.
A lot of people watching this set. Can't really tell on the camera, but.
Oh!
Is that gonna be it? Last stock, game 5.
Oh, that DI! Ooh.
Oh! That's it. Good stuff to both
players.
All right,
Finio clutches that out.